Okay, so I have to click the PPT or something. Okay, so I can start now. And please keep the PPT in this thing. I can open this PPT now from here. Okay, so I welcome all of you to a unique session on role of Indian Railways in managing supply chain during COVID-19. Today I feel extremely happy, and it's a matter of great pleasure to represent the work of Indian Railways, which is being carried out under the most difficult situation of COVID-19. And you would really appreciate, and as a citizen of India, it would be a matter of pride for all of us to see that how Indian Railways has supported not only the supply chain of the industry, but the supply chain of the human being in our day-to-day life. So I am Professor Thakkar from National Rail and Transportation Institute, Vadodara. It is India's first university focused on transportation-related education, established by Ministry of Railways, Government of India funded. I take this as an opportunity to acknowledge NPTEL, which has extended this excellent opportunity to express my views on the work of Indian Railways during COVID-19. I am grateful to Madam Alka Misra, Vice Chancellor, National Rail and Transportation Institute, Vadodara, for her support and encouragement. I am highly thankful to Mr. Jitendra Singh, Executive Director, CC, Railway Board, for his most valuable inputs and suggestions. I extend my thanks to Dr. Venkatesh Chintala, a faculty at NRTI, and Mr. Ashish Gupta, founder and director, 9.9 Consulting Group, for sharing their valuable views. Before I go into the topic, I would just like to present a small scope of the NRTI. And as I said, it is India's first university focused on railway and transport technology related education. The university is created under the vision of Honorable Prime Minister Narendra Modi, and it is established with a focus to create a dedicated resource pool based in class professionals in the, say, domain of railways, supply chain and transportation sector. At present, the university is offering 4 undergraduate programs which are extremely unique in terms of course curriculum and the scope, and the 6 postgraduate programs with the collaborations with the international most leading universities like Buckingham University, MIT and Cornell. And the institute and university is trying to add value in the domain of supply chain, logistics and transportation. If you see, the key imperatives of COVID-19 and the role of Indian Railways, then Indian Railway, I would say, it has acted as a warrior. During COVID-19, whether you take the initiative of Shramik Special Train or transporting the goods, day-to-day items or any other essential commodities, if you look at the COVID-19, then it has set the new normal for healthcare, education, manufacturing, and the policy structure in government and private is under huge transformation and reform. COVID-19 has transformed the human life and supply chain, and when we cannot do much with the COVID-19 in absence of vaccine and other medication available, Indian Railways has acted as a backbone to the life of the nation and supported all the activities necessary for our survival. This presentation will highlight the key contributions of Indian Railways in managing supply chain during COVID-19 by addressing three pillars of an effective supply chain. When I refer to three pillars, it means flexibility, adaptability, and resilience. The agenda of this lecture is set like this. I will try to brief about the Indian Railways, its contributions, and how it has evolved. We all are aware about the supply chain management, but I will just try to touch some of the key dimensions of the supply chain. What are the key issues and challenges we all have faced during COVID-19? And specifically, the theme of this lecture, an exemplary, a terrific response of Indian Railways during COVID-19. Post-COVID-19, opportunities for Indian Railways and some of the future directions. And finally, I will summarize with the key insights. Indian Railways, a lifeline to the nation, a warrior in COVID-19, and is the fourth largest rail network in the world. If we see some of the statistics, it really makes us proud. Indian Railway is among the world's largest rail network. Indian Railway route through, say, length network over 123,236 kilometers with 13,452 passenger trains and more than 9,000 freight trains from 7,349 stations plying 23 million travelers and 3 million tons of freight daily. India's railway network is recognized as one of the largest networks under the single umbrella of Ministry of Railway, which is really a great example of sustainable organization. It runs 21 stations across India. The scope and the orientation of Indian Railway has changed over a long journey of 160 years. Indian Railway believes in maintaining the legacy of traditional systems, and it also welcomes the modernization in infrastructure, technology, information, and all other facets. The pictures which you see here are some of the snaps, advancements of the Indian Railways. Continually, Indian Railway and the team of railways is trying to upgrade the facilities for the betterment of the citizens of India. If we just quickly see some of the milestones, then the journey started back in 1837 and the country's first train, Red Hill Railway, was started, which ran from Red Hills to Chindratpet Bridge in Madras. Subsequently, 1853, the first India's passenger train was operated with 400 people. 1986, as a pilot, computerization was introduced in New Delhi. 1988, the first Shatabdi Express started. 1990, the first self-printing ticket machine was introduced. And subsequently, you can see that in 1998, coupon validating machine were introduced in Mumbai. 1999, nationwide concede system began operation. 2002, IR began online freight reservation and ticketing. And 2018, Indian Railway added one more feeder, and Ministry of Railway started the Institute, National Rail and Transport Institute in Vadodara. 2019, introduction of Vande Bharat Express train, which has basically supported the, it is indigenously built engine-less semi-high-speed train, and it is meant for intraday travel and expected to reduce travel time by 10 to 15%. 2019, Indian Railway has entered into the collaboration with Alstom SA from France and manufactured 12,000 HP locomotives at its Madhepur factory. The hauling capacity is 6,000 tons and can reach a maximum speed of 120 km per hour. Way Forward 2020 is the situation of COVID, and I will present the various initiatives taken by Indian Railways during the time of crisis. Beyond 2020, Indian Railway has a systematic plan for the development, modernization and growth, and there are many areas, I would say, whether it is the implementation of IoT, automated maintenance, green procurement, green, say, locomotive and energy efficiency savings, and many other initiatives which are way ahead, and Indian Railway is seriously and rigorously working on those initiatives. Some of the recent initiatives I would just like to highlight which are taken by Indian Railways. Din Dayal coaches. Why a good facility cannot be extended to a normal, say, citizens of the India? And with this thought, say, the facility like portable drinking water, mobile charging points, bio toilets, and other things are introduced in the unreserved coach Din Dayal, the name given. Executive lounges. Why we cannot have a feel of sitting at airport when we are reaching to a railway station? And Indian Railway move ahead in this direction by having some collaborations with Leela Palace, and they introduce the concept. Gatiman Express, which covered 200 km distance between Delhi and Agra in 100 minutes, and it is equipped with 5,500 HP electric locomotive and many other facilities. CNG train in the area of energy saving and reducing the environmental, say, pollution, green fuel is introduced in Indian Railways, and 1,400 HP engine was started. The another initiative is Talgo. The Indian Railways introduced Spanish Talgo, a light train consuming 30% less energy. Similar way, there are many other initiatives like operations 5 minutes. There should not be any hassle, and the maximum time taken for buying a ticket at counters is only 5 minutes. Project Nilgiri. Google and Indian Railways have joined the hands and came up with Project Nilgiri, and 400 railway stations are targeted to provide the Wi-Fi hotspots. Bio toilets is the recent initiative and very well taken by Indian Railways, and it is trying to install bio toilets in all the coaches to ensure the entire rail network has zero discharge zone by 2019. Not only this, but it is also targeted that the use of biodiesel up to 5% of its total diesel consumption, and this will be tied with solar and wind energy to reduce the emission in a significant way. If we see some modernization in Indian Railways, then online monitoring of rolling stock system, typically called as OMRS, and this has helped Indian Railways to have smart yards being implemented for machine-assisted automatic identification of defects in the rolling stock. And this initiative helps the Indian Railway to identify the faults, defective wheels, maybe bearings, and many other, say, defects beforehand, and undertake the appropriate maintenance without causing any damage, say, to human life, and so on. What is supply chain management? just to have a small brush up, we are trying to leverage 6 SCM dimensions or drivers, and the most important, which has extreme influence on the other dimension, is the transportation. So facility, inventory, transportation, information, pricing and sourcing are the 6 levers that we try to say integrate in order to improve the efficiency and effectiveness of the supply chain. And in my view, in the country like India, where we have to cater the diverse market, if you see the consumer behavior and the market structure, they are diverse. If you see the remoteness, urban region, connectivity with the rural, the people, their affordability, and many other dimensions, then the reach out to the people and having a sound transportation system is the most vital for improving and maintaining the supply chain efficiency. Typically, we say that we have a supplier, producer, and customer, and we try to balance the flow of cash, material, products in the reverse, and the information flow to see that the lead time, whether it is at the manufacturer end or at the customer end, can be drastically minimized and the total supply chain revenue can be maximized. So this is the whole spirit of our supply chain, and transportation has a great role to play. There are various dimensions like value, distribution, logistics, information, inventory, cash flow, upstream and downstream management. And if I look at to all these dimensions from transportation point of view, then I can say that transportation is the backbone of the supply chain management. There are some key SCM facts that would help the audience to appreciate the importance of SCM and subsequently the need of a sound transportation system and the response time typically in the situation like COVID-19. World Bank research in Latin America showed that reducing the share of logistics in the final price of goods by 14% can increase demand for those goods by 8 to 18% and increase employment in that sector by 2.5% to 16%. This impact is particularly extremely important for micro, small and medium enterprises in the country like India, which provides a large scale employment to the people. Specifically for agriculture products, another critical sector of the Indian economy, we cannot underestimate the importance of logistics and transportation. Let us just see the data and some statistics. And here, the logistics cost is represented as percentage of GDP. You can see that because of very good infrastructure, connectivity, intermodal transportation, USA, this cost is only 9.5%, Germany, it is 8%, Japan, 11%, and India, 14%. The difference you may see is only 5% or 4%, but this makes a huge difference when you try to appreciate it in terms of percentage of GDP. And this has a great impact on our economic cycle and keeping the wheel of economy running. Transportation is a key logistic function and is critical to supply chain performance. To meet the vigorous requirements of the supply chain, we must have a dynamic strategy. We must have the ways and means by which the various modes of transport can be integrated so that the consumer and the industry, whether it is the household or maybe the industry, they can be provided the services at the best in terms of cost and responsiveness. Let us try to appreciate our pains during COVID-19. And rather, I would say pain. COVID-19 has posed some of the issues and challenges for the people and for the industry. The first one is increased use of collaboration tools. More devices means more attack surfaces. Today we are busy with Google Meet and many other technology, but when this technology provides the convenience, there are security issues also. Unsecure home networks, connectivity, insider threats, growth in unemployment. Because we are working in a digital world at present, people may grab the employment from anywhere in the world, and this may lead to, say, grabbing of opportunity for the local people. Compliance challenges. We are working with the digital world, but organizational and government compliances need to be appreciated and followed. Larger adversarial landscape, we can understand the world has become one. Lack of talented cybersecurity officials, stress on employees and supply chain issues. Here I would like to give you a small analogy which will really bring a feel of pride in all of you. Just think, 1990, we had an operation airlift. The operation was executed by Air India, evacuated 170,000 people by civil airline from Kuwait. If you see the 2020, similar operation in different way is carried out by Indian Railways. And in my way, I will give the name to this operation as COVID-19. Just see the figures, which are really, say, worth appreciating. 4,465 parcel trains were moved by Indian Railways. 17.96 million tons of food grains was transported, and 4,000 trains to help 60 lakh people get back home. So, the task performed by Indian Railway is massive, and I wanted that these facts must be appreciated as a citizen of India by all of us. And we must see that today, if we are getting the food, today, if we are getting the medicine, if industries, their supply is uninterrupted, then it is because of Indian Railways. We can appreciate more by appreciating the contribution of Indian Railways in terms of three dimensions of the supply chain. Resilient, adaptable, and flexible. I really feel very much proud in saying that the organization, which is 160 years or more than that old, with a huge administrative system, lakhs of people working, has shown that despite of all the constraints, the organization is flexible. During COVID-19, they have provided the Shramik special trains and converted their coaches into the isolation coaches as a part of their adaptability. And we can see that Indian Railways have run the longest train ever, which is 2.8 kilometer long, called Shesnag, to be highly responsive to the need of the people of the country. So resilient, adaptable, and flexible, these three unique dimensions this organization has demonstrated, and it is nowhere a small thing to really execute under the critical situation like COVID-19. If you see some of the response to COVID-19, then entire world the people, all the private and government organizations, we were struggling. But it was an Indian Railway which was not sitting still. The organization was dynamic, continually planning and trying to satisfy the various supply chains like food, healthcare, vegetables, and other essential commodities across the country. Indian Railways, an uninterrupted and unstoppable supply during COVID-19. Just see one of the fact that Indian Railways has transported more than 1 crore liters milk with the help of Dudh Duranto special train. The coals, other minerals and necessary supply to industry and power plants were ensured, and you can see in other picture that with the help of security forces and all the precautions, Indian Railway has acted as the lifeline to the shramiks, laborers of various trades in supporting their transport from their workplace to their home place. So, couple of facts if I present, then in the first 8 days of the lockdown period, a total of 1,012 trains of essential commodities have been transported from the jurisdiction of East Coast Railways towards different destinations of the country to help relief effort. Let us systematically go through and appreciate the initiatives. So the first initiative which I found most promising is uninterrupted 24/7 freight trains operation to ensure availability of essential commodities throughout the country. From 24th March to 13th July, more than 48.56 lakhs wagon carried supplies to keep the supply chain functional. Of this, more than 26.06 lakhs wagons carried essential commodities like food grains, salt, sugar, milk, edible oil, onions, fruits and vegetables. And Indian Railway and the staff, they worked 24/7. Locomotive pilots, guards are efficiently running the trains. Key maintenance staff of track, signaling, overhead equipment, locomotive coaches, all were put under operation and continually they were extending the services. Institutional mechanism was put in action and zonal railways in good train operations to control room set up by Ministry of Home Affairs. The another initiative which we are always appreciating is running the parcel special trains. So zonal railway are regularly identifying and notifying the routes for these parcel special trains, and they are presently operating 96 routes, and mainly these routes have been identified to include regular connectivity between major cities of the countries like Delhi, Bombay, Kolkata, Chennai, Bengaluru and Hyderabad. Connectivity from state capital, important cities to all parts of the state, supply of milk and supply of other essential items. Sheshnag, as I said, 2.8 kilometer train which has boosted the freight transport. And the train was operated between Nagpur and Korba in Southeast Central Railway. The initiative 3, in less than a month since Government of India gave approval, Indian Railways has run over 4,000 trains to help 60 lakh people get back to home. We talk about the logistics of the material. We talk about the logistics and shipment of the goods, but here it is a highly sensitive and emotional issue. It is about managing the logistics of the people. And when we say people, the safety, their emotional dimensions, their catering, their most essential requirements like food and other things has to be planned very, very meticulously And Indian Railways has really shown an exemplary example in meeting these requirements. Shramik special trains, I can present some data that 4,615 special trains were run, and top states from where trains have originated are Gujarat 22.4%, Maharashtra 17.7%, Punjab 9.3%, and so on. Top destination states where trains have terminated are Uttar Pradesh 37.4%, Bihar 35.3%, West Bengal 6.1%, and so on. And the total movement of the people included 63.1 lakh precisely. Free meals on Shramik special trains, 1.93 crore meals and 2.14 crore packaged drinking water were sold. Railway has fully accommodated the requests received from the sending states in the best possible manner. If I look at it as a researcher from supply chain point of view, then there are three key issues in handling the entire operation of Shramik special trains. Nodal officers of the railways who ensures the interaction with the states to get a rough estimate on requirements of the trains. The other entity is states. They must indicate the projected number, provide the detailed list, and facilitate the logistics and the movement of the people. The Indian Railways service provider, with the help of nodal officer and states, they immediately schedule the train based on the requirements by states and UTs in consultation with the nodal officers. So it's a classic example of managing the supply chain and logistics with the help of these three entities, which acts as a central, say, node in managing the logistics of the people. I can pose a couple of issues which can be further explored as a part of research or the case study. Challenge one is scheduling. It's not an easy task because railway is not only arranging the Shramik special trains, they also have to look after the need of the industry and supply the food grains, fertilizers, cement, coal timely, so that electricity, medicine, other essential things don't get disturbed and their supply remains uninterrupted. Challenge two, planning and coordination. I already mentioned that at the state level, the coordination is required. Nodal office with the railway staff, Indian Railways, and this poses a great challenge in terms of planning and coordination. The story doesn't end here. The challenge three is intrastate movement. Nearly 75% of the trains were bound for Uttar Pradesh and Bihar, and most of the balance trains were also headed towards Eastern India. And it was a challenge for railways to come forward to help several state governments even to meet their intrastate movement of the people. Initiative 4, select passenger services. So here, Indian Railways have gradually restarted passenger trains because after lockdown, there was, say, the huge need to transport the people and catering their, say, professional requirements and other things. So during the period of unlock, gradually, Indian Railways have started from 12th May 2020, 30 trains, and they started seeing that the normal life of the people can be restored. Further, 200 Mail Express, primarily non-air-conditioned trains, have commenced from 1st of June 2020. And obviously, they are very much careful about the safety of the people, and some of the norms were made, say, compulsory, like wearing face cover, undergoing screening, and only asymptomatic passengers are allowed to board the train. Initiative 5, central control center setup. When we talk about the supply chain, the information flow and the coordination are two most important issues, and for this purpose, Indian Railways has set the control cell is manned round the clock to monitor calls received on railway helpline. Emails were also received and replied, and actions were taken, and the monitoring was put in action through social media, trend analysis to communicate and alleviate any difficulties faced by the railway customers and other people taking timely actions. Initiative 6, which was remarkable and most important, 5,000 beds in hospitals earmarked for treatment of the COVID-19 patients and 33 isolated hospital blocks in railway hospitals have been identified for the treatment of COVID-19 patients. So this you can see as a part of CSR, corporate social responsibility, and they have not only restricted themselves to the function of transport, but also extended a huge help to the citizen of India by extending the healthcare services. 10,500 quarantine beds were offered by Indian Railways. Initiative 8, conversion of coaches to serve as quarantine and isolation facilities. We all know that in India, in many places, people, they stay in a very small house, and it is extremely difficult to maintain or practice the protocol of COVID-19, specifically the social distancing. To help the people of India, maybe a deprived class, typically the coaches were converted into quarantine isolation facilities, and some of the figures you can see that coaches requisitioned by state 763, Delhi 503, UP 220 and BR 40 and so on. Initiative 9, we were also needing the personal protective equipment, and it was a massive challenge to produce such things, and Indian Railway were nowhere behind even in catering this most critical need of the people. So Jagadhari workshop of Northern Railway has designed and developed a prototype of coverall, which was cleared by DRDO laboratory, and over 1.8 lakh coveralls of PPEs have been produced till date. Initiative 10, removal of long pending infrastructure bottlenecks during lockdown period. See, for many organizations, it was a lockdown where the other activities were not really undertaken, but Indian Railways has productively utilized their time. Many maintenance related work in pipeline, and employee, instead of sitting idle, they took it as an opportunity, and a huge amount of, say, maintenance work like rebuilding and rehabilitation of bridge, limited high subway road under bridge in lieu of level crossing gate, and yard remodeling, commissioning of doubling and electrification, and many other activities, whether maintenance or development, were undertaken by the staff employee of the Indian Railways. So they have utilized this time to make themselves prepared for the better services in future, and definitely these advantages are extended and the quality of service is improved for the citizen of India. If I just summarize some of the key contributions of Indian Railway during COVID-19, then trains were transporting coal, so power plants would supply electricity to homes and hospitals. Just one coal train, if you see the figure, takes 200 trucks off the road. More trains were transporting fuel to ensure pumps didn't run dry. The credit goes to Indian Railways. IR moved with uncharacteristic speed to shift huge quantities of the food grains and other essential supplies across the country. I will little bit deliberate on this issue in the subsequent slide. Several Indian Railways department also took advantage of the lockdown, and they did a massive maintenance work during this period, and IRCTC may not have sold many tickets during the lockdown, but they fired up their base kitchen instead. They since have provided tens of lakhs of meals to the straddled and needy free of cost. So the credit goes to Indian Railways and their employee for the massive work carried out during COVID-19. 5,000 railway coaches, as I said, were converted into the isolation wards. Other at Indian Railways facilities were busy too. They repurposed available supplies to make sanitizers, masks, personal protective equipments, hospital beds, and many more things. If we see an exemplary response of Indian Railways in leveraging the efficiency of food supply chain, our economy is dependent on the agriculture, and without timely transport and supply of the food grain, the people of country can face huge challenges. So typically, if we see the facts, then biggest challenge for India during COVID-19 was to ensure the uninterrupted supply of the food grain to deficit states. And this was critical because though the FCI, Food Corporation of India, has a staggering 77 million tons of food grains in stocks since March, it is dependent on the railways for racks to evacuate food grains from the Punjab, Haryana, and to the procuring state, supply it to the procuring state, other state like Andhra Pradesh and Chhattisgarh. Outward movement of wheat and rice from Punjab and Haryana has substantially increased. An average loading from Punjab, for example, has increased from 15 railway racks per day in most of February and March to about 25 racks a day in April. So Indian Railway, they took it as a challenge, and in May 2020, Research Design and Standard Organization, the research arm of Indian Railways, launched new milk transporting tanker that could hold 44,660 liter, which is much superior to the existing tankers. I would also like to deliberate on a couple of post-COVID-19 opportunities for Indian Railways. And these are not only the opportunities, but it sets the future roadmap for Indian Railways. So typically we learn a lot in the situation of crisis, and these learnings can be effectively utilized for shaping our future. So Indian Railways should use the current COVID-19 crisis as an opportunity to create a new business model, and we may consider this as zero-based assessment. What we were doing previously, fine, we were doing fantastically. The crisis has come. We went by flexibility, adaptability, and resilience. We transformed our practices. And this transformation has brought a lot of learning, competitiveness, and the efficiency for the future. And the same applies to the transportation sector and Indian Railways. If we just see a couple of opportunities, then Indian Railways plays a vital role in meeting the day-to-day requirement of the people, supporting the life of the people, and contributing to the economy of the nation. While the overall intermodal share of the rail in freight traffic is around 35%, it continues to account for a major share in transportation of bulk commodities and the freight transport. So during the COVID-19, it has been realized that freight transport can be a huge opportunity, scope, and the area where Indian Railways can come out with some innovative solutions which can bring a profitability for the organization and the competitiveness for the industry. Future focus areas, if we just highlight, then it has been realized that there are two key factors to be considered. One is availability of alternative modes of transportation and the affordability of the rail compared to other modes in terms of distance and time. The time has come that we need to reorganize the passenger segment. the kind of services by the citizens required by the industry, they are of different category, and segmentizing or reorganizing the customer segment can really help the Indian Railway to develop a good pricing and revenue model for the competitiveness of the Indian industry as well as the Indian Railways. The other area is strong focus on the freight transport, and this is something where remodeling and restructuring is required. The third area is diversification of freight traffic. There are many models available, like IR can explore maybe container services, parcels, cargo, trains, RORO, that is called roll-on, roll-off, road railer, and many other things. Typically, if we see, then the Amazon and many other, say, e-retailers, they were highly supported because of Indian Railways, and the massive transport of the goods through aggregation was achieved by Indian Railway, and the longer transit time as well as the uncertainties transit time are some of the issues which can really be addressed for diversification of the freight traffic. In addition to this, I would propose that Indian Railways has huge data, and today we all know it is a digitized world. We look for the trends, patterns, knowledge hidden within the data, and this is possible with the help of artificial intelligence. Whether it is the customer specific data, whether it is the consumer behavior data, whether it is the affordability data, or it may be, say, industry specific requirement data or maintenance data, the huge data set is available with the Indian Railways. Researcher can even come forward and they can develop the algorithms, they can develop the tools which can really help to tap the knowledge behind the data. Internet of Things, already Indian Railways has considered this as a priority. For example, how old my track is? If I have the real-time data, or I can capture the real-time information about various facilities, then the timely maintenance and the necessary services can be arranged. Similar way for prototyping and maybe real manufacturing, 3D printing, for surveillance, drones, DNA data storage, which can accommodate the massive data storage requirement, and quantum computing, with the very high-speed computing facility, Indian Railways can really improve, accelerate their competitiveness. I would just like to share my views on some of the ideas on restructuring supply chain during and post COVID-19. What we can see here that there is something called supply chain preparedness for COVID-19. If you look at the dimensions which I have considered here, then it is supplier relationships, geographical diversification for flexible purchase and manufacturing. Third is inbuilt agility and adaptability to reconfigure the global and local market, and implementation of risk management and mitigation strategies. I would say that if an organization, in terms of its supply chain preparedness, is type 1, means somewhat prepared, then I will say the first dimension, supplier relation, is strong, geographical diversification for flexible purchase is high, inbuilt agility is high, and implementation of risk is implemented. Type 2, partially prepared, and type 3 is ill prepared. Now, you must be wondering that as a researcher, where would I like to put the Indian Railways? I would rate the Indian Railways high because the type 1 here starts with somewhat prepared, and the kind of agility, flexibility, and adaptability, the three most important pillars of supply chain, Indian Railways has catered I will say that Indian Railway was fully prepared to cater the emerging need and the crisis requirement of the people of India and the supply chain preparedness of Indian Railways was very high. Some of the indicative supply chain skills for future, irrespective of the industry or segment, big thinking, inclusive of technology development and advancement change leadership, control travel leadership and single point of command management skills, data analytics, a typical risk management to improve upon your resilience and responsiveness, and holistic and global leadership, including the ability to work seamlessly within and across companies. The top five priorities post and during COVID-19 would be keeping the trains moving. This is the lifeline. Repeatedly, I am saying we cannot stop. Going the extra mile. Yes, today there is a need to cater the various customer segments, and I have to think about the provisions or the arrangements like Shesnag train. I have to think about, say, huge transportation of the food grains. I have to think about, say, providing the quick response to the passengers suffering under COVID-19 situation and safety and many other things. So going the extra mile. Looking after staff, employee, Indian Railways. I would also like to appreciate and give a huge credit to our doctors, nurses, and the paramedical staff who have acted as a backbone and supported our life. So we must look after the staff. Working with government. See, government under the situation of crisis, they even have to rework on their model. They even have to come out with new and novel strategies because the future is uncertain. The guidelines coming from WHO, they vary sometimes. And in accordance to that, government is also expected to restructure their policies. So the organization need to work with the government and formulate and reformulate their policies to see that they can really help the society. And obviously planning for the future. To summarize, as a concluding remark, I would say that Indian Railway, Ministry of Railway, and the most important being now National Rail and Transport Institute, which will act as the most critical pillar for our nation in terms of developing the talent in transport and supply chain sector, I would say that our Indian Railway has the history of more than 160 years. Fourth largest railway in the world. It is the perfect example of both traditional and modern system. You would see they operate with even some very classical old trains, but highly effective, and they have modernized themselves to the large extent by offering the various services like Dindayal coaches, maybe online ticket booking, or maybe adoption of artificial intelligence, IoT, robotic-based maintenance, and many others. It's an exemplary example of sustainable organization. It has survived, progressed, and served unstoppable since last 160 years. There are huge research opportunities in the domain of engineering, technology, and policy planning. From this platform, I appeal, request the researchers across the world to see Indian Railway as a great opportunity for research. And there are many areas from technology, management, policy, frontier that we can work together and come out with not only the good publication, but really extend the value of our research to the society and the people. And it is the lifeline of the million of people of India. Before I close my session, I would like to say what I have highlighted today is just a trailer, tip of the iceberg of some of the contributions of Indian Railways. If I have to narrate the 160 years of contributions of Indian Railway, then maybe it would be a full-fledged course, and we can evaluate as a researcher from various angles, from OB, from HR, from operations, from engineering and technology, the various initiatives and advancements adopted by Indian Railways. I would, with a very emotional touch, I would like to thank our Indian Railways for their unstoppable services to the nation. On behalf of the citizen of India, I express my deep gratitude and salute and pride for Indian Railways. I request my audience to offer a big round of applause to Indian Railways by posting their clap online. And with this, I really thank you very much. This is the beautiful campus of NRTI, and we have a palace in our campus. We have peacock, the most natural setting. And I request all of you to sometime visit the institute, interact with us. And I thank you very much for your patience and appreciating the services of Indian Railways for our nation. Thank you very much. I am here to address your queries. Okay, I hope you can hear me, and I would like to take up couple of comments, couple of questions from the list. There is a comment that how Indian Railway cover the loss of lockdown. This is where I want to once again thank Indian Railways and the government that this organization stands for the cause of nation. It is not only the service to the nation, it stands for the cause of nation. And yes, obviously there is a huge loss, and Indian Railway could not operate for a long period of time for passenger trains. There is a huge loss, but they stood for the requirement of the nation, people and industry, and definitely Indian Railway will come out with some revenue sharing model where it also becomes our responsibility to see that we support the initiatives of Indian Railway and Government of India, and see that our Indian Railway can recover partially maybe some of the loss which it has encountered during this period. So fine, your question is really genuine and valid. The other question is that, is civil engineering is not a better field which designed COVID-19 hospital in this present era than railways? Thanks to civil engineering and all the professionals, it's not the time and occasion to compare one profession with other. When I say Indian Railway comprises all the fields: civil engineering, electrical engineering, mechanical, information, computer science, you name the field. And railway can demonstrate that where they are contributing or what professionalism they have. So definitely the role of civil engineering is very, very important in meeting with the COVID-19 challenges. There is another question related to my institute, NRTI. Is there any PG program offered for working executives in distance mode? I welcome your question. I have just highlighted that NRTI offers at present four UG programs, and six PG programs. Yes, here is the slide. Now your question is, will there be any program for executives? Definitely, it is in our plan. I would like to say I have joined NRTI after working at IIT Kharagpur for 10 years as a professor, and definitely I would like to take up many programs with the help of my team, and many such programs for executives were conducted at IIT Kharagpur. So it's a good question, and we will definitely be extending our services to the need of the people. I can just take up one or two more, say, queries. Okay, there is another example from technology front. How does the technology adoption in the Indian Railways compare with developed countries? See, let me tell you very honestly, when I was developing this presentation, I started putting some of the global initiatives, and then when I compared it with our Indian Railway, I found that either mostly we have done or adapted many of such things. Yes, we may not be having many bullet trains or in this area we need to work, but we have adapted many technological advancements, whether it is IoT. Yes, this area need to be strengthened, whether it is in terms of the cloud technology or whether it is in terms of the automated maintenance. We have already started and we are doing, but certainly our network is huge and large, so we gradually will increase the scope of these activities in comparison to the other developed countries. Let me see one more two question. Okay, many people, they have appreciated that role of Indian Railway in COVID-19 is very helpful. Here is a great opportunity for design, management and technology. So there are some appreciations also. And fine, that is done. So I think I addressed the comments posted by my beloved audience. And once again, thank you very much for your patience and appreciating the role of Indian Railways in the service of the people.